Go ahead and give your behind little behind the scenes story.
So that one's a weird one because me and my brother Grant, actually, we kind of co-produced it. It was more like I did more of the legwork and he just kind of like pointed me in certain directions. But he's really good at music too, so sometimes I'll ask him for a little help. So I made the beat before I made the before I even wrote any of it. I believe it was a freestyle, or at least the hook was a freestyle. Yeah, the I just remember I remember making the hook and the melody, and I hadn't made the beat at all yet. And then I called my brother. I was like, "Bro, listen to this." And I just played him the melody with my vocals over it. And he's like, "Yeah, bro, do put this as the beat pattern." And then I listened to him and did it. And then he told me all the little things to add in that I should add in. He didn't know necessarily how to make them. He just was telling me that this sound, like he would make the sound with his, like with his voice, and then I would be like, "Oh yeah, I can use this to add it in." And then I made that, which I mean, that song's, you know, I mean, it's pretty easy to tell. It's talking about a previous relationship and how I deal with them. And then I sampled my grandfather. I was having a conversation with him, and he actually doesn't know that he's on this song at all. I was sitting having a conversation with him, and we were talking about music, and he just started playing music. And I would just pull out my phone and turn on the voice memos and start recording.
Oh my goodness, bro. See, the story definitely enhances the song.
Oh
Because
yeah, but
without.
most people don't even know. People probably just think that that song, like the sample I added in, they probably just think it's some random shit I just found on the internet. Nah, bro, that's straight up my grandfather playing guitar
Yeah,
and singing.
that's what I thought. I thought it was just a sample that your dad was. I thought it was dope. Had no idea it was your grandfather.
Yeah, man.
Yo, you should put like featuring your grandpa or something.
No, I want it to be kind of like a mysterious type shit.
I get the mystery behind it, but after finding that out, that changes the ranking for me. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are my thoughts on Heart Got Colder. So I have here S my favorite, A banger, C it's a cool record, C it's not for me, D cap. Now this to me is in between banger and cool record. I don't have an answer yet. Bec what makes
Yeah.
it what makes it a banger, bro? Because I'm so close to putting it as a banger. But what makes it so close to a banger is that it's a beautiful introduction. That's the like for a first track, dude. That is like perfect.
Oh yeah, it's like a good tone setter.
Yeah, dude. And then what you're telling us that it's your grandfather on the record. Yeah, dude, that's a banger, bro. That's a banger, dude.
Oh yeah, and he says like one of the craziest lines I heard in a song, because he's singing like gospel, like literally he writes gospel and he's singing it, and he's like singing at the end, and he literally says, "They prey on us while we pray to you." And I was like, that is like the hardest line ever put into a goddamn gospel song I've ever heard.
That deserves a t-shirt.
Oh, God.
Someone will get that tattooed on them. Shout out your grandfather, bro.
Oh, God, man.
And you know
And
that,
he just up with that shit, man.
yo, it's that kind of energy that gets trapped in a song, and it translates.
Yeah, it's wild because fucking bro, no one's heard his music at all. Like, bro, literally he literally sings in a church to
That's
the
awesome.
churchgoers. That's it. That's it. No one's heard his music, really.
Only like the locals know, huh?
Yeah.
Bro. All right, for starting good, bro. Fire start right there, dude. Track number two, Fahrenheit. Let's go.
Yeah,
this beat.
Oh yeah, it's fire.
This view from our hotel, yeah. Came to Magic City, hope it go well, yeah. Temperature of the situation, I just can't tell. Got this stupid bitch up on my phone, think I might yell. I'ma throw it from my balcony. Anxiety might work for you, but bitch, it never worked for me. All these hoes talking on my Insta, yeah, I know they want the worst of me. Mad cause I never wipe them up, yeah, they ugly me. Bitch, my love ain't free. And if for sure ain't cheap, never get too confident cause I might leave. I'm not what a fucking bitch want, I'm what a bitch need. And I stay up every night cause I ain't getting sleep. How the fuck could I get sleep when they sleeping on me? I got motivation, they wish they could take it from me. Baby, please get naked for me. Staring at this view from my hotel, yeah. Came to Magic City, hope it go well, yeah. Temperature of the situation, I just can't tell. Got this stupid bitch up on my phone, think I might yell. I'ma throw it from my balcony. Anxiety might work for you, but bitch, it never worked for me. All these hoes talking on my Insta, yeah, I know they want the worst for me. Mad cause I never wipe them up, yeah, they arguing me. The fucking person standing right in front of me. I just want a bitch that's gonna tell me she won't ever leave. Ooh, ooh, yeah. Man, I can't believe it, all my fucking friends leaving me. Must be karma for all the bitches that I just fucking leave. Staring at this view from my hotel, yeah. Came to Magic City, hope it go well, yeah. Temperature of the situation, I just can't tell. Got this stupid bitch up on my phone, think I might yell. I'ma throw it from my balcony. Anxiety might work for you, but bitch, it never worked for me. All these hoes talking on my Insta, yeah, I know they want the worst of me. Mad cause I never wipe them up, yeah, they arguing me.
Yeah, bro, that song's real good.
Bro, did you say you're gonna throw her off the balcony?
No. So that line, I'm saying, I might throw up from my balcony. So the whole song is called Fahrenheit, right? Yeah. And it has to do with anxiety in relationships and a woman who manipulates you, and kind of like also has to deal with like the thoughts that you're having afterwards when you break up with them. So like, I say the reason why the song's called Fahrenheit is in the song I'm like, temperature of the situation, I just can't tell. Stupid bitch up on my phone, I think I might yell. So it's like, it's kind of wild because it's like, I'm saying temperature of the situation. It's talking about two things. I'm talking about literally my body because I'm getting stressed. And when you get stressed, your blood pressure goes up, your face gets red and hot. And then I'm saying temperature of the situation because, you know, it's like it's a heated situation.
Yeah. Damn. You need to incorporate that in that music video if you ever make one.
Oh, yeah. And I literally say, aim to Magic City, hope it goes well. Like, I'm literally talking about, like, the transition from going from a small town to a big town with a lot of people. And being like a social outcast kinda, where I'm like, literally, I would only ever see the big city at times, right. And I would see it from the distance, and so it looks magical from a distance because it's like all the lights and the shimmering, you know, from, you know, just a little farm town on the side, and then you finally move into the big city, and it's not really as great as you think, and the people aren't really all that great there.
For real.
Yeah.
Damn, dog. Man, I don't know if you're gonna like this comparison or hate it. Check this out. This is the vibe I'm getting, bro. Like, obvious, dude, I mean it with my whole heart. Like, you are a one of one. You're an originator. No one has your sound. And it's incredible how multi-talented you are. You know, so I give you your flowers every time I talk about you.
Sounds like Travis.
Say what?
Kind of sounds like Travis a little bit.
I was going to say, like, it's your own type of like Travis Scott sound, but you also have like you're your own Drake is what I was gonna say.
Oh yeah,
you're your own version of Drake
in a way. Yeah, I feel like yeah, that's a good comparison, not in the sense of like I feel like I'm like, I don't know, better than Drake. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not trying to be all egotistical and shit, you know? Obviously, bro has put in a lot more legwork than I have into this shit. But yeah. I would say that my potential could get to where he's at.
Damn. Bro, Drake is like, he's an earth god, bro.
Pretty much, man.
That fool is an earth god, dude. He's insane. That's, I don't know
how he would
say what.
He definitely is.
Dude, I don't know how you would deal with that kind of fame, bro.
Well, see, I'm already like a socially isolated person, so I feel like, honestly, it wouldn't be that much different than right now. The only difference is I would spend way more time inside, and I don't know how I'd feel about it. Honestly, I don't know how I'd feel about fame at all. Honestly, I'd probably, like, bro, if I became famous, I would literally probably move me and my family out to, like, fucking Switzerland on top of, like, the Swiss Alps and just, like, have a mansion up there and just not deal with anyone.
Yo, for real. Or you're going to get lost. You'll be corrupt. Or unless you know how to manage it. Because I feel like Drake manages it. He knows how to deal with it, you know?
Yeah. He's got a really big team around him. And that's the big part about it is having a team.
And being so consistent and still having love after all this time, bro. Who else has done that? I would say like Lil Wayne has in a sense. But he's not a big name as he used to be. He's a GOAT.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Because he's not dropping. It's because the thing with Lil Wayne is he's not dropping bangers like he used to.
Right.
I mean, he dropped the Carter 5, which was a fucking crazy album, but he also dropped like two albums before it and two albums after it that were not that great.
But what's so crazy is that what? Carter 5 was what? 10 years ago, bro? 8 years ago?
No, Carter 5 was 2020.
Nah, for real? Alexa.
Yeah.
When did Carter 5 come out?
According to when Alexa answers is it saying that? 2018.
Damn.
Yeah, yeah. So, dang, so yeah, that was like 5 years ago then, wasn't it?
Damn. I guess, is that the one with Kendrick?
It still is.
Mona Lisa?
Yeah, it is, and it's got XXXTentacion on it.
Yeah. Yeah, that one
it must
was a
have
good
came
album.
Out at like the very end of 2018.
Yeah, September.
Because I worked at a grocery store when it came out.
Oh, you know where you were at that during that time?
Yeah, yeah. Because when I listen to music, I listen to it literally like on repeat. Like if it's really good, yeah. I'll bump it literally every day at every point. So
I feel that. Feel that. Fahrenheit.
Oh,
say what?
Hold on, before you say anything, I wanted to let you know I'm re-uploading all my old music on everything.
Are you?
Dude, yeah.
What's the story behind that, dude?
Well, I feel like I let the comments get to me too much. Yeah. And I really honestly had something special.
100%.
Back then, and I feel like I kind of fucked around and messed up a little bit by removing it for so long, because literally for the past like 3 years, every one of my fans has been like, "Bro, please re-release all your old music."
Yep.
Just constantly, like I'll get like all these fans like messaging me on Instagram. They'll be like, "Bro, when are you gonna drop? I love you." Again, or
damn.
When are you gonna drop the Cat Houses album again? And I'll be like, oh, you know, just kind of BSing a little bit. But now I'm like, fuck it, I'm trying to drop it,
bro.
Because I've been re-listening to all of it, man, and it's crazy. I honestly was making bangers, like I was singing in key with no auto tune and shit, like honestly, I was doing something special before I even knew I was doing it.
Bro, I'm going to say it here on stream. As soon as I get 30 to 50K in my savings account, we got to do a documentary, bro.
Yeah, bro, that'd be fucking gas.
That would be dope, bro. I think that would be dope.
It most definitely would be. Also, Starfield is about 13 minutes away from downloading.
Starfield, for real? The video game?
Yeah, it just came out, bro, today.
What? That's crazy. No way, bro.
Yeah, I'm downloading it right now.
Hey, you're going to have yourself a good night.
Well, I'm probably fixing to go to bed. It's going to be more like I'm going to have a good night tomorrow night. That's when I get off work.
I feel that. I feel that.
But I'll probably open it and play it for a couple minutes tonight.
Dope, dude. Yeah, I think I might check out a stream later.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I don't really have time to play video games, sad face. Or actually, I've been playing Limbo, though. I ain't gonna lie.
I've been playing hella games, bro. Fucking Diablo, Diablo 4, fucking Borderlands, Zombie Army, Dead War, Outlast 2, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Minecraft. I've been fucking balling, bro.
I've been hearing people talk about the chainsaw.
Oh, yeah, dude. It's fire.
Is it?
It's like Dead by Daylight, but, like, way better.
What? Dude, Dead by Daylight is really popular.
Yeah, well, I think, honestly, if Texas Chainsaw Massacre pulls it off right, Texas Chainsaw could be bigger.
Damn. Interesting. We'll see.
It's pretty fire, bro. It's scary.
I'm gonna have to check out a trailer because I've been hearing a lot about it from the fam, but I haven't even seen a trailer for it. I've kind of been out of the limelight with video games, unfortunately.
Oh yeah, I'm always up to date with video games. It's like my second pastime besides music.
Damn, you don't stream? You playing, bro? Missing out.
Bro, I'm bad about, like, doing more than, like, two things at once. So, like, you know, me making music, playing video games, working my job. Yeah. It kind of, like, I don't know. I, like, whenever I'm streaming, playing video games, I'm sitting there worried about, like, what I look like or how I'm playing. It's just not as fun as just sitting there and actually playing it.
True. It's a different vibe for sure.
You know, because most of the time when I'm playing games, I'm not fucking talking or anything. I'm just watching and listening. And if you stream and all you do is watch and listen, then it's going to be a bad stream.
I've seen them, though, bro. I've seen streams with people just standing there playing. They don't see a word. Not a peep.
That is wild.
I mean, I don't stick around that long, but I've seen some.
Oh yeah, people definitely do that, but it's like most of those ones aren't really terribly big.
True. Thought I ask. So Poop, I'm gonna put Fahrenheit on cool record. That's a cool record.
Yeah.
And it was
actually the next song is gonna be like what's below S?
Banger.
So B.
Right, let's see. I hate myself. Ooh. Damn, bro, your production's crazy.
It's either gonna be an S or B.
Say what?
So it's either gonna be an S or below that. Right below that.
Distracted, I focus. Aim for the stars, yeah, we sorted. Only when you're doing good, they notice. Got my way. Red, black, Cadillac. Shades on, they match. Yes, I got my reasons to laugh. Yeah. myself, but I tell myself that I need some help when I know the help. But I keep on getting high, draw some help, but I taste some more when I can't just help but cry. Lord, just tell me why I can't seem to die. No more drama, my eyes keep on telling lies. They can see inside where my pain resides. Distracted, I focus. Aim for the stars, yeah, we sorted. Only when you're doing good, they notice. Got my way, red, black, Cadillac. Shades on, they match. Yes, I got my reasons to lack.
Damn, bro. IVY, bro. He's a really good singer, dude. You guys flow well, really good.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he don't fuck with me, though. Which what? Is weird. Yeah, bro. He tried making me not release the song before that came out.
Why? Is there a story time for that?
I mean... like, I don't know necessarily why. I know why he told me. He said that he was, like, rethinking music and everything. And he was like, I'm not sure if I want to release the song anymore. And I pretty much was like, too fucking bad.
Damn.
I was like, I don't give a fuck if you want it released or not. You've waited about 6 months.
Damn.
Tell me.
Damn.
I'm dropping. Regardless, yeah.
So. Bro, if I send you something, it's yours now. It doesn't matter how I feel a year later. Like, I sent it. I recorded it, you know?
Yeah.
Like, what the hell?
Motherfucker, you're going to have to, like, send me a cease and desist before I take that shit down. Like, dead ass.
And he did a great job. He's just probably subconscious.
For real. I literally told him that, but at the same time, I feel like bro just don't like the song. Which is like, it's whatever. And my music is a completely different vibe than the type of music he makes.
Oh, for real?
But, I mean, he's one of them dudes who, like, pays for streams and shit like that. And I mean, like, if you listen to that song and then you go listen to all of his songs, there's a pretty stark quality difference.
Okay. Okay.
Which I'm not trying to talk shit. I'm just saying it's like, bro, like if you don't like the song, you're crazy.
Damn. Music industry like that. Damn.
Yeah. Which is whatever.
Let's all get along. Don't.
Yeah, for real.
Bro, again, this record is literally between banger and cool record. I'm gonna have to just leave it here for now in between, because I feel like it could be, I think my problem is it could be a single, you know, it could be a great hit with a music video attached to it. It has that potential.
I feel like most of this album is like, it's like you don't understand how good the song is until you got a music video for it.
And that's what you do.
Yeah.
That's what you do, bro. All right, so that's what it looks like right now. All right, let's jump to our next record. We're looking at... And I like how you did this. You know, for everyone that needs to know, I Hate Myself and Want to Die is the title of the album. And he has track 3, I Hate Myself, track 4, and I Want to Die. Oops.
Yep, that's which cool. I mean, technically that song's name, the And Want to Die's song's actual name was Note to Self beforehand, but then I just changed it to the And Want to Die parentheses Note to Self, because I was like, I feel like And Want to Die is a more accurate description of the song, but I feel like Note to Self is a good way to, it would probably be something that somebody would search up if they were like listening to the song.
Right. And you know what? I'm giving you props. That's my first time seeing something like that on the track listing following like the title of the album. Having two tracks like finish it, like that's new. I haven't seen that.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen that either. I just, it came to me.
Props, dude.
Yes, sir.
Wake up.
He done changed, he ain't the same. What's his name? So let's change. If you ain't got nothing good to say, you can keep it to yourself. Don't you think you changed too? If you still worry about yourself, bitch, you need some help. Note to self, are you really working hard? If you ain't working on yourself, thank God I made it out and I don't wanna kill myself. No, you'd understand it too if you just ever asked. Cause this alcohol got me kinda sloppy. They can't hold the same status to themselves. Cause now I'm 22 and I don't like to play about my mental health. Cause now I'm thinking about who like too much. Kinda know for these bitches too much. I've been hoping for the best too much. I've been in and out of stress too much. He ain't the same. What's his name? So let's change. If you ain't got nothing good to say, you can keep it to yourself. Don't you think you changed too? If you still worry about yourself, bitch, you need some help. Note to self, are you really working hard? If you ain't working on yourself, thank God I made it out and I don't wanna kill myself. No, you'd understand it too if you just ever asked for help. Bitch, I'm grateful. Bitch, I'm grateful. Bitch, I'm grateful for everybody in my life that's made me thankful that I'm alive. Even though I wanna die, I'm feeling like I'm Jesus Christ, I'm crucified. Cause they wanna bury me alive. I hope you find your peace. Even when I die, I'm good for him. I'm too good for him. I'm too good for him. He done changed. He ain't the same. What's his name? So let's change. If you ain't got nothing good to say, you can keep it to yourself. Don't you think you changed too? If you still worry about yourself, bitch, you need some help. Note to self, are you really working hard? If you ain't working on yourself, thank God I made it out and I don't wanna kill myself. No, you'd understand it too if you just ever asked for help.
Bro. Yeah, bro.
Damn, dude. That is a record right there, dude.
Yeah, man. Fucking, yeah, that one's kind of like me talking to myself. Like, I'm literally saying, like, I literally said in the song, like, like I said, he didn't change. He ain't the same. What's his name? Like, I'm literally talking, like, about myself. I'm, like, saying, like, damn, I've changed. I'm not the same anymore. And then I'm, like, I literally say in the song, I'm, like, I said, are you really working hard if you ain't working on yourself?
Yeah.
I forget what I said after that. Like, it's the note to self part. I said, I literally said, are you really working hard if you ain't working on yourself? Note to self. Which I'm literally saying, like, yeah, I fucking know I want to kill myself. I'm fucking working on it. Give me time.
Damn, bro.
Yeah.
Yo, did you ever watch that show Moon Knight?
Uh-uh.
Oh, damn. It's, I kind of recommend it, but he like, he's like talking to himself. And he's like one of those weird superheroes, and hearing you just say that kind of reminded me of that. Like, that's actually a really cool concept for like a video, if you ever think about that.
Yeah, man.
Bro, that's a banger, dude. That's an easy banger. The beat, the lyrics, the hook.
Oh yeah, dude, it's fucking it's definitely one of my favorite. I like it. The melody is actually made by a very famous producer who's produced for who was it? I want to say like XXXTentacion and produced for like Travis Scott too, I think. I forget her name. But she's a big producer.
Powerful beat. Oh, yeah. Dude, I mean, going back to you as an artist, like, I want the success that you want, but like, you can get success in any which way.
Oh yeah.
You know, 100%, and I believe that.
Oh yeah, definitely, bro.
So AB is about, yeah. Right?
Huh?
AB is about, like, short for about, what about me?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just double check in. All right, bro, track 5, let's get it, bro.
Yes, sir.
Got a different artwork right here.
Yeah, that's a single for that.
I like that.
All the strums, I'm seeing shit. Don't lie to me, don't be a bitch. She crying me, now I'm feeling shit. She hiding shit, now I'm feeling it. Yeah, ooh, ooh, ooh. What do I do? Try to be strong though, but this pain is lifelong. All the strums, I'm seeing shit. Don't lie to me, don't be a bitch. She crying me, now I'm feeling shit. She high shit, now I'm feeling, yeah. Ooh, 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 what do I do?
That's A tier. I mean, S tier. S tier. That's my favorite right there, dude. S tier. That's going on a playlist, dude.
Yeah, everybody been saying that's a good song, man.
Yo, that's good. That's good feedback, dude. I love that record.
Yeah, that's the one I dropped the music video for.
Okay. Yeah. we gotta watch that video again. Can you give us a little behind the story on that one?
It's fairly simple. It's like What About Me. It's literally talking about a period in time where I was losing my mind, pretty much contemplating suicide, talking to God, literally being like, what about me? Mm. Like, I literally, like, in the song, I'm like, hand up to God, what about me? What about me? What about me? And I'm like, I'm so alone. I'm so alone. Stuck in my home. Stuck in my home. The things that I did, I need to atone. I'm literally talking about, like, yo, I fucking hate myself. I'm stuck in my home alone because no one likes me anymore. Because of all this, like, shit that I did that's not good. Like, fucking people's girls and shit. Just fucking around being a bad person, you know?
Damn.
And it's all coming back to bite me in the ass. And I, just kind of like a self-reflection thing. And I literally said, talk to my mama. She said I did nothing wrong. I feel like she's wrong, though. Nowhere to belong, though.
Damn.
I try to be strong, though, but this pain is lifelong.
Deep, bro. Deep.
Yeah, and it's like, the hook's like, off the shrooms, I'm seeing shit. Don't lie to me, don't be a bitch. She cried at me, now I'm feeling shit. She lied to me, now I'm feeling it. I'm literally saying, like, I'm like talking about being on shrooms and reminiscing about the women in my past who've like manipulated me and shit, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying, like, don't lie to me, don't be a fucking bitch. Like, yeah, bro.
Hey, yo, one thing I'll add to that, like, bro, if you can survive a tornado, you can survive anything, bro.
No, you're not wrong, bro. You are not wrong.
I mean, it's they're a little old school now, but for anyone that's gonna watch later, check out the Pook interview. He has a few of them on Upper Radio. Gives a they crazy still story.
Hold, they still hold up to this day.
Yeah,
I feel like
classics, dude. Classics for sure.
Definitely, like a lot has happened in between, but like this still holds up. I mean, the things that happened in that. Like, the things I talk about are still fucking crazy, so.
Yeah, you have, what, was it the shroom trip or the acid trip?
I think I talked to you about really, like, all of it.
Yo, some wild stories. Everyone got to check that out. It's, Pook got a interesting, fascinating life for sure.
Yeah, bro, it's a wild-ass life, man. I feel like I'm not even real sometimes.
That's what I'm saying. Like, this needs a documentary. Your life needs a documentary. It would be really interesting.
Yeah, bro. I feel like that sometimes. I feel like if people knew me, they would get my music so much more.
Mm-hmm. I agree to that.
It would add a layer, but it also kind of scares me too, because I'm like, I feel like if people knew me, then I would just, like, it would just increase this, like, weird fandom bit that I don't know if I like, you know?
Damn, you could even, like, later down the line make a TV show out of it.
Oh, God.
I think it's bigger than a movie.
No, for real. I feel like a movie would be pretty, pretty wild. I feel like a TV show. I feel like I can make a TV show out of it.
That'll get some crazy ratings right there, dude. I can see it happening, bro. You know?
Yeah, I'm God, man.
100%. This existence is a trip. I definitely see it happening.
Yeah, bro.
Track 6, dude. Never Enough. Yo. So What About Me has your lowest plays, which is crazy, dude.
Yeah, so I think something weird happened because I dropped it before all the other ones.
Oh, wow.
And it didn't get pushed by the algorithm.
Makes sense. Man, that one's my favorite right there. And then
it's a good song.
Right after, that's your one with the most plays. So here we go, dude. I'm excited to hear this. Never Enough.
Because the end was near. But there were some asshole instructors that would hear the happiness and go right on past the end point. When that happened,
I think never
everybody stopped talking. Heads would start dropping.
Damn.
And I started taking fucking souls. At that time, I knew what happened in their minds. They were living off the hope factor. They hoped the instructors would stop running. They hoped the water was never cold. They hoped the weather was fucking good. I don't live off that hope shit. I wish the water was cold. I wish them motherfucking instructors keep on fucking running. I wish for fucking rain. When the ending is unknown and the distance is unknown, that's when you know who the fuck you are.
All these bitches went out bad, I'm on some different shit. Grew up fast, things go bad, but I can't never switch. I'll get a bag, they want me back, but I don't need a bitch. I try my best to hate my ass, but I don't notice it. And I try to do my best, but now I'm stuck in my bed. And my mind be racing every day, can't get out my head. And I'll never be enough for those who left me for dead. We ain't cool, we ain't boo, we on some other shit. Bitch, no, I'll never be enough for you. No, I'll never be enough for you. So I guess now it's fuck you too. And trust me, baby, I ain't tryna be rude. No way, fuck that. Try this shit, you be better off cut that. Lucky as fuck that I did not cuff that. Remember them days of watching them rugrats, jumping around on top of them playmat. Yeah, I wave at them, know they gon' wave back. Doing good, and I know that they hate that. All these bitches went out bad, I'm on some different shit. Grew up fast, things go bad, but I can't never switch. I'll get a bag, they want me back, but I don't need a bitch. I try my best to hate my ass, but I don't notice it. And I try to do my best, but now I'm stuck in my bed. And my mind be racing every day, can't get out my head. And I'll never be enough for those who left me for dead. We ain't cool, we ain't boo, we on some other shit. Bitch, bitch, I'm lit, 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 so my dick. Don't give a shit. This bitch is broke with kids. So how she judging how I live? And bitch, I'm on some different shit. You still wanna cut my wrist, now I wanna ice out with. Brand new whip, I just wanna bitch is gonna sell my dick. All these bitches went out bad, I'm on some different shit. Grew up fast, things go bad, but I can't never switch. I'll get a bag, they want me back, but I don't need a bitch. I try my best to hate my ass, but I don't notice it. And I try to do my best, but now I'm stuck in my bed. And my mind be racing every day, can't get out my head. And I'll never be enough for those who left me for dead. We ain't cool, we ain't boo, we on some other shit. Bitch.
Damn, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Hey, yo, nah, that's a banger, but I'm putting it in my favorites. Feel me?
Yes, sir.
Damn, that one's crazy.
Yeah, man, I fuck with that one.
Damn, dude, how were you feeling with that record?
I enjoyed every single song I made for the album pretty much equally.
I like that. We're more than halfway, and the feeling of this album is really good, bro.
Yeah, bro. I feel like I definitely made something special.
Oh man, you most definitely did, dude. But man, I mean it. But I say that with every album that I listen to by you. But this one's crazy. Tell Me You Love Me, track 7, bro. Let's get it.
Oh yeah.
Man, your beat selection and your beat production is insane, bro.
Yeah, bro. I really honed in my beats with this album, to be honest.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me you love me. Just tell me you love me. I know you love me.
She
understand me, cause it seems like everybody can't seem to stand me. Tell me you love me, just tell me you love me. I know you love me, I know you love me. Just tell me you love me, just tell me you love me. I know you love me, I know you love me. And she can't seem to get along with me. So now I'm up at 3 a.m. and I can't sleep. Me can't take it back. Hey, when you lying behind my back, I look like a fool. You can't take it back. I wasn't that mad when you take it there. I know that you love when I pull your hair. I need me a damn bitch that I don't share. Now why are you acting like you don't care? Baby, please just love on me. Like fuck you, I don't need a thing. You'll be crying when I spread my wings. Yeah, I'll blossom like the flowers in spring. Just tell me you love.
It's freaking crazy, bro. It's a banger, dude. Big banger right there. I got to hear I Hate Myself Again. Make a decision there. But we got 3, an A tier, 2, an S tier. Let's not waste no time, bro. Snakes in the Grass. I do remember this one. I do remember this. And if my memory serves me right, it's going right into
hoes ain't less, yeah. I just told my mama I've been living way too fast, yeah. Told my mama there's some snakes in the grass, yeah. I can't eat off a bean in my dreams. All I see is death of me. Won't you tell me what that means? Sipping lean as a teen. Hey on me, can you see? I ain't mean. I just need love of me, yeah. My thoughts have been kicking my ass like I'm walking and stepping on glass. I left all my friends in the past, smoking the back of the class. All I got is $20 left for some gas. God judges for what I did in the future. Satan's watching for what I did in the past. Lamenting how I've been living too fast. When I slow down, God, I think I might crash. I ain't dead yet, but I might in the flash. Time to get up and make up my past. I just broke up with my problems in the past, yeah. I just broke up with my hoes, ain't less, yeah. I just told my mama I've been living way too fast, yeah. Told my mama there's some snakes in the grass, yeah. Too, but too scared to take off the mask. Eyes all around is ready to light up the ass. But how we supposed to grow if we can't look in the mirror and grasp the person we dodging at last? Only God can judge me, plus a couple people on Twitter. All that good isn't gold, but that's not what the internet told me. Time to take our Lexapro and cop on the rolling. Fogging up the mirror just to wipe it down slowly. I just woke up with my problems in the past, yeah. I just broke up with my hoes, ain't less, yeah. Told my mama I've been living way too fast, yeah. Told my mama there's some snakes in the grass, yeah. I can't eat off a bean in my dreams. All I see is death of me. Won't you tell me what that means? Sipping lean as a teen. Hey on me, can you see? I ain't mean. I just need love of me.
Dude, Snakes in the Grass. I got put my charger on my computer. Yo.
That one's probably one of my favorite records.
definitely S tier. And we got two more records off this 10-track tape.
Oh yeah, bro. That's definitely a banger song.
Bro, yeah, that gets an easy S tier, bro. We got two more records. Yeah. Don't Commit Suicide. I have not heard this yet. Track number 9. Oof. Two more records. Looking good.
It's a sad one.
Damn. I don't even know where to put that record. It's so crazy. It's so cool that you're being so transparent, though. Damn. I mean, I can't put that as a... I mean, I could, but it's not... I might have to put that on cool record, bro. It'd be kind of crazy calling that a banger. You know, like... I mean, it could be a banger for those who are really feeling like that right now, that need to hear something like that.
Yeah.
Damn, but I felt your energy on that record, bro.
Yeah, I feel like that's just a song for the people who really feel that shit, bro. I feel like right now, people who are listening to music as a whole, people who want to off themselves aren't really listening to music about it too much. I feel like there are a lot of people who do, but I feel like most people don't want to listen to music about it because it makes them think about it more.
Oh, you're right.
But at the same time, it's like, I mean, I'm being transparent, but I'm also like being like a bit too transparent, and it's kind of like dark as fuck.
Yeah, I've never heard someone sing a record like that. Like, don't commit suicide. Like, that is so straightforward.
Yeah, because it's like, I've wanted to do that a lot.
Damn.
And it's like, I put out this album. Honestly, I was kind of scared to put out the album just off the title. Because, right. You know, honestly, bro, I put this album out and I got a lot of people like messaging me being like, bro, what's up with the album name? And I'm like, well, guys, I've told y'all this a lot in the past. Mm-hmm. Like everybody who knows me knows that I've wanted to do that in the past. It's not nothing's changed up to this point too much. I mean, I definitely don't want to really do it anymore. But the feelings that made me want to do it are still there somewhat. I just know how to deal with them better.
Yeah.
You know, and but it's like this album's kind of like me talking about the road to understanding how to deal with depression.
Damn, bro. That's crazy. Like, that's a, like, that's a soundbite what you just said. Like, your homies, people hitting you up being like, yo, what's up with the title? And you're like, bro, I've been telling you this. Like, ain't nothing changed, really. Like, that's crazy, dude.
Well, it's just, it's like, it pissed me off because it's like, I've given everyone plenty of warning signs.
Yeah.
It's just whenever I say it fucking blatantly outright now, they want to, as you know, it's like sitting there, you're like, damn, I've been cutting my fucking leg for like 3 months and I got some blood stains on my pants. But it took me saying I fucking hate myself and want to die on an album cover for someone to actually reach out. It's like, y'all are fucking a trillion fucking minutes late on this. Like, if I was going to kill myself, and you know what I'm saying? Like, if I actually fucking went through with it, they wouldn't have even known, I guess.
Damn. Well, I mean, as frustrating, or even another word I can't even use right now, as you can feel about that situation, you know, like, bro, you're still here, though. Like, thank God you're still here, bro. You know, and...
Yeah, weird. I mean, I still, like, at times I'm like, I don't want to be.
Right.
Which I feel like if you're a person who deals with that, it's never going to 100% go away. You just have to give yourself reasons to stay. And I just happen to have enough reasons to stay.
Having just enough to stay is every good reason, bro. Like, you know, I'll say it right here online, bro, and I think I've said it a couple times to you, like, dude, if you ever, because I'm a Christian, right, if you ever need prayer, bro, I can say specific prayers. You know, a lot of people go, well, I'm not really a believer or this and that, and my counter to that is like, well, if you're willing to take your life, take any kind of medicine you can to help you, and in my case it's prayer, you know. So you know that.
See, I believe. Oh, go ahead. Sorry, bro.
I was going to say, like, we've known each other for so long, and for the most part, I would like to feel like I've been as transparent and as loyal as I could be from afar, you know, because we never met each other in person, but we've known each other for years now.
Yeah, bro. Definitely. You've been a real one.
Thanks, bro. And I'm here for you, dude. I hope you know that.
Yeah, no, I know. I got a lot of people, you know? Like, I really, truly do. But it's one of the things where it's like, it's not really something I can help too much, you know? It's kind of like, you know, you're born into a... It's like you start out... Let's say you're, like, playing Skyrim, right? It's kind of like playing Skyrim... And you want to be a warlock, but you decide to play as a fucking Khajiit. It's like, the Khajiit's got fucking skills that are set up for a thief, not a fucking warlock. So, of course, you're going to fucking not be able to play the game correctly.
Right, right. That's a good analogy.
You know? Yeah. It's like, that's how I feel about myself. I was born... into a society I was unprepared for, with a set of attributes I was unprepared to deal with, and
I feel you, bro, and I totally understand the analogy you just said, and it makes sense.
Yeah.
And no one would know how you feel about yourself. We could only see. And again, I'm just
I feel like there's people out there who probably do understand how I feel. I feel like I make my depressions too vague for people to truly know how I feel. Like, whenever I talk about it, I talk about it a bit too vaguely. Like, even with my therapist, I talk about it a little bit too vague.
That's crazy.
Need to open up about it more. But it's one of the things where you kind of, like, indoctrinate yourself into vagueness to almost protect your mental, because you don't want to even think about it slightly. You don't want to even remotely think about this depressing thing that you have in your life. So you cope with it by faking confidence your entire life and trying to never show, like, yourself crying or anything like that.
Damn.
But truly, you're just like the most depressed, anxious, you know, uncomfortable human being. I was talking with my girlfriend the other day, and I was like, I don't think you truly understand how genuinely uncomfortable I am at every point of every moment in my entire life. I mean, I may seem comfortable at times, but it's more or less just me being comfortable in the uncomfortable. Like, it's gotten to a point where it's so uncomfortable that I just have learned to sit and not exhibit uncomfortable trait in my actions. It's kind of like dying on the inside.
Even though you just talked about how even with your therapist you're being vague, like, bro, I think what you just did was extend more of your vulnerability just now, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
That's big.
It's right difficult there. At times. The wild thing is, I've only ever really talked with like maybe like five people in my entire life about exactly why I'm depressed. Because it's just like, you know, it's one of the things where it's like, literally, bro, I told myself at like 8 years old, like, bro, I'm literally never talking to anyone about this. And the fact I've talked to five people about it scares the fuck out of me. And, you know, but I've learned to kind of accept it at this point. And I'm just like, okay, I've talked about it. And then what's even fucking worse is on top of the fact that I have this like just unrelated, you know, depression issue here, then I also have PTSD from the tornado. So I've been going to my therapist for a minute, and she diagnosed me with PTSD not too long ago. So that's another one. It's wild.
Damn, that's a new thing, huh? That she diagnosed you with, you said?
Yeah, never knew I had it, but honestly makes hella sense. Like, a lot of sense.
It does make sense. That's crazy. Bro, okay, so from what I'm hearing, it sounds like you said that if you kind of be a little bit too vulnerable and you told the truth on why you're depressed and this and that, that you would lose control of that, right? You're trying to hold on to it because you don't want to go to that next step. Is that what I'm kind of hearing?
Yeah, it's kind of like you just don't want people to know how actually like depressed and depraved you are inside. Just because it's like, yeah, I mean, it's like taking your clothes off in front of a crowd. Like 90% of humanity would not want to do that.
Yeah.
You know? That's the way I feel about it, you know.
Well, dude,
it's like being exposed.
I mean, it's a lot of folks will say it's kind of unfair for me to say what I'm going to say because I'm not in your shoes. But, bro, I'm one of those people that would take off my clothes with you to let you know, like, bro, you're not alone. And in my existence, yeah, I believe there's an afterlife after this. But here, this is just our one life. And I would highly recommend just, like, let it out, bro. It's like, let it out. If you're already feeling this way and you feel like you've been suffering and depressed, bro, go full at it. Or take steps at it, of course, with your therapist and talking to your girlfriend. Like, those are beautiful things that you're doing. Just lay it out, bro. Just lay it out.
Yeah, and see, like, I have laid it out. And, like, I've laid it out to quite a few people. And I'm almost to the point where I'm going to lay it out with the therapist so that we can really work on it. But I've told her about a lot of shit, man.
Yeah.
But fucking just not that one. It's like that's the deepest cut, you know, and I just haven't really gotten to that yet. You know, I only spend about an hour with her a week, so
I feel that, bro.
It's hard to fit everything in. I mean, think about all the things I've told you about my life and then try to fit that in an hour.
Impossible. Yeah, it's impossible.
Yeah. And yeah, bro, it's difficult, but I'm managing. Every day is a struggle, to be honest. I'm getting there. But I've always got the backup plan. If I ever need to, I can always get back onto my Celexa. which is honestly a pretty good medicine for depression, and I used it quite often. But I mean, honestly, bro, I've been in a pretty good mental space. It's just like dealing with anxiety is a tough one. A real tough one. And honestly, if I ever get back on to Celexa, it'll be probably because of panic attacks and anxiety. But I mean, it is how it is.
Man, at least you do have a backup plan and you do have people around you.
Yeah, definitely.
Including me, bro.
Yeah, man, I appreciate everyone.
Yeah,
like literally, bro, in the song, Want to Die, Note to Self, I literally said, bitch, I'm grateful for everyone in my life that makes me feel that makes me feel important to be alive, even though I want to die.
Crazy poetry, bro. Deadly poetry.
Yeah, man, it's...
Damn. I know from life experiences, dude, every one of us have a complicated, demanding life. But, bro, I could always spare. It doesn't take much for me to spare 5 minutes. If you ever, even on my busiest day, I could take away 5 minutes. If you ever need to talk, if you ever need a prayer, whatever the case is, dude.
Yeah, of course, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, bro, of course. Man, thanks for sharing that, dude. That's a lot. And you know, I don't know how many views this is gonna get later on, but hopefully someone out there will hear it or even listen to your album, right? And it correlates.
Yeah, bro.
100%.
I hope people really understand the shit I'm trying to convey with the album, because I feel like one of my biggest issues is conveying the message I'm trying to put across. Because I feel like I feel like the first playthrough of the album, you really won't get all of it. And I feel like most people are going to put the album down after the first listen, you know?
That's today's days on. Like, everyone not listening to albums these days.
Nah, yeah, for real. But, I mean, at the same time, it's like, it's possible people will get into it.
I think it's making a comeback, dude.
Yeah, I mean, it's got streams. I mean, I'm sure while we were even just on here, it's gotten some streams and likes on it. Riley, chill, bro. It's my dog.
Shout out Riley, the dog.
Yeah, bro. You know what's funny? My girlfriend's name is the same fucking name as my dog.
For real? Yo, that's tight. That's tight. That's crazy.
Funny as fuck.
Damn, now I need to make I need to find me a girl named Bella. That's my dog's name, Bella.
Yo,
we'll be twins, bro.
Bella, Belle Delphine.
Yeah. Yo.
Belle Delphine. I would smash the fuck out of Belle Delphine, though.
She was. I mean, I don't know what she's doing these days, but she was dope, bro. She was making moves.
Oh my god, I would fuck the shit out of her.
Bro, to be honest,
and honestly, I hope she's like, if I ever blow up, I hope she sees this in the future. God damn it, I hope my girlfriend don't see this.
Yo, I was gonna say, like, I think her momentum.
She's gonna be like,
say what?
No, you go ahead.
I was gonna say her momentum died after she did her OnlyFans, bro.
Facts.
Sucks. She was like popping. I feel like she was making all the. I think if she really wanted to do OnlyFans, she should have prolonged it, bro.
I think she just switched from one thing to the other, and the other thing that she switched to is just not in the public eye a ton.
Interesting.
You know?
Interesting. That's a good point.
So it's like, if she, like, she's not focused on, you know what I'm saying? Like, she wasn't a streamer, you know what I'm saying? Like, she wasn't streaming, really. Like, she literally became famous for, like, Instagram posts.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, you didn't know that?
Nah, I would see her in interviews. That's how I got to know her.
Yeah. So she got famous for that Ahiago face or whatever it's called. But she would literally just do cosplays on Instagram, and she would make that fucking face.
Yeah, the face. Yeah.
And people were like, what the fuck, this bitch literally looks like she's getting fucked.
Yeah, she was like one of the main faces I would use on Upper Radio. And I mean, one day I hope I could do an interview with her. That'd be badass, bro.
Oh god, let me come along.
Dude, I'm hoping I can do that. Matter of fact,
and I would literally just be in the interview being like, I'm not gonna lie, you're fine as fuck.
Poogie wild dog.
Oh god, I'm the type of guy who like if I think a girl's fine, I will tell them to their face.
Yeah.
But if they like if they just seem like they're not feeling it, then I'll back off.
Yeah, you got the swag, bro.
It's weird. I feel like I fake confidence a lot. This is the weird thing. Like, I'll be confident as fuck, and then once I get past like step number one, I'll be like, oh. Fuck, I wasn't thinking this far ahead.
Damn. I got an improv.
And then I'll be like, damn, what do I do now? Like, I'll be like, literally got the bitch at the crib or something, like texting the girl. And I'll be like, damn, I did not think this far ahead.
That's hilarious. Damn. Yeah, you just gotta go. You gotta improv after that.
I mean, improv is a good way to put it. I pretty much just like, I don't even know. I just like default to like being myself, which is like not necessarily always the most attractive to women, like my personality. Because I feel like a lot of women just like are not particularly comfortable with a guy who is like 100% authentic. And, like, isn't afraid to, like, share his emotions and stuff.
Bro, forget those girls, dude. When I date a girl and I go, you want some SpaghettiOs? and she look at me weird, then just get out the place, dog. Like, leave. Like, I'm not gonna waste my time on honeys that don't care about who I am authentically. Like, Pook, you're
that's why I fuck with the girl I got.
Yeah, I like that. I like that, bro. How long y'all been together?
Not too long, like 2-3 months, something like that.
Super dope. Y'all been in movies yet?
Oh God.
Okay. Did you watch the Oppenheimer movie?
No, we watched Strays.
Okay. Man, haven't been to a theater in a minute, bro.
Oh yeah. I love going to the movie theaters, bro. It's fire.
I used to go all the time back in the day, but times have changed.
You were gonna tell me something a couple seconds ago. You said poop, and then you just I interrupted you.
I was gonna say, I think I was gonna talk about like being authentic. Like, you don't want to be around a girl who we gotta fake the funk anyways. Like, there's so many fish in the sea.
Bro, I've ruined like multiple relationships because I just could not fake being myself around the girl.
Oh well, right? Like, oh well.
No, for real. Like, bro, for real. Like, I was with this girl.
Yeah.
And like, example, right? You watched iDubbbz, right?
SciDubbbz?
iDubbbz, like the YouTube channel.
Oh yeah.
You ever watched her?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know how he made that documentary about the airsoft fatty guy?
No, I didn't watch that one.
Well, it's essentially like a big, long documentary making fun of this kid and his friends. Like, dead ass, bro. Like, if you go watch it, bro, you'll be like, what the fuck? Like, this is actually just like a dude making fun of someone. Like, it's not even funny. Like, you know, like, it's not funny. But it's like, like, I was mad watching it, bro. Like, I was actually mad watching it because I was like, damn, bro, because like, I've been fat, you know, like, right, extremely fat in the past, and I was like, bro, if somebody made a fucking YouTube video about me talking about me like this,
oh damn,
I'd be mad. I'd probably cry, honestly.
Damn. Yeah, it sucks. Like, it does suck.
And but I told the girl I was with, because we were watching it together, I was like, honestly, because I was a pretty big iDubbbz fan at the time, and I was watching it, and I was like, honestly, I don't really fuck with this. Like, and this is the moment, we've been dating for like 6 months, and this is the moment that I realized, oh, this bitch, I'm gonna end up having to leave. I told her that, and she was like, oh, the guy deserves it because he puts himself on the internet. I was like, oh, you're insane.
Peace out. Later.
Yeah, I was like, you're just one of them like Reddit people who like shit talk.
Damn, bro.
She's like the embodiment of like the people who comment on fucking TikTok, bro.
Oh, for real.
People who just like say shit without thinking about the consequences of their actions afterwards.
I see it too.
You know, like,
kind of like an NPC, like, they'll,
yeah, yeah, like they'll see like somebody has like a gap in their tooth or something like that on TikTok, and the person's just sitting there like having a good old time, just having fun making TikToks.
Yeah,
but they got a gap in their tooth, and then you go look at the comments, and it's just like 10,000 comments saying, damn, this bitch got a big ass gap in her teeth. It's like, no fucking shit, you don't have to fucking say that.
Cold world, bro.
You know,
it's a cold world out here. Sad.
For real. And it, what's sad, even worse is like, that's the shit that's like, you know, the youth is really gonna be and pick up on. It's like, that's not what we need for society.
Yeah, it's sad, but unfortunately most of the people in the world are like worms on the ground, dude.
Yeah. Just, it's sad.
Just super mean.
Yeah.
They should have gotten more hugs as babies.
No, for real. But I feel like even some of the kids who got hugs end up fucking being like that.
You think so?
Yeah, definitely, man.
I think that, honestly, like, if you have a good dad and mom, there's no reason for you to turn up like that.
No, sometimes things happen with no real good reason behind them.
Like a borderline?
Yeah, kind of like, example, fucking, I just lost my train of thought. What was I talking about? I'm sorry.
you said that you disagree kind of with, even with a good parent, you'll still turn up bad.
Yeah. So, like, for example, like me, bro, fucking, I don't have a dad, but I have one good mom. You know what I'm saying? Like the statistics and what people say would indicate that I would end up being a bad kid. You know?
But wouldn't you say if you did have an excellent father, you would be in a much better place?
I think yes, but at the same time, there's too much other shit that happened that would have influenced me regardless. Having a good dad would have just given me, it would have given me somebody who was more stern to tell me, like, hey, fuck off, quit doing that shit. Whereas my mom was kind of a pushover and let shit happen.
I feel that. I just think I feel what you're saying, but I have a strong feeling if like the world had most if they had their parents and they were good, decent people, at least it would be less evil. Like, I agree, there's still evil out there, bro. You know, there's different
borderlines. I feel like that's like the first step. For a good kid.
That's a good point.
I feel like some kids are just born fucking psychopaths, though. On God.
Yeah, it's true. Like, their DNA is like been messed with over time.
Like, literally, just inevitable that they're fucking terrible.
Well, I mean, at the end of the day, like, humans suck, bro. And we have to understand that we suck. Like, there's no one perfect. Like, we're freaking hypocrites. We're full of shit. Like, no one's a saint. Like, we suck, but we do our best, you know, to be the best we can be, I guess, you know, to the extent. Like, I do my best to be a good dude, but I'm not perfect. I still make many mistakes daily.
I mean, we all fucking make mistakes, bro. I'm fucking goddamn prom subject of that.
Man, but it makes good art, bro, right? Damn.
It definitely does, but I feel like fucking Van Gogh just sitting here losing my mind, cutting my ear off and sending it to people, you know?
Yo, what if Pook was from a different country, dude?
I feel like I am.
Yo.
Yo. Sometimes I wish I was black so I could just say the N-word because it would make things so much funnier.
You should get a ancestry test.
It's like, it just says, like, Pook is a fourth black.
You should, like, bro.
Dang, bro. Then I'm just going to go around to all my black friends and be like, can I say it?
Can I say it? You'd be like, you're going to have, like, the issue logic has.
It's right here.
Damn, bro. That's wild. That's a whole video right there, dude. You taking the DNA test?
Oh, God.
Bruh, we got one more record.
I already know I'm fucking German.
No, you sounded German saying it. You did, well, bro.
I know I am. Like, because my family on my mom's side is German.
Know how to make some good sausage and potatoes?
Oh, God.
The schnitzel?
Yeah, I mean, sadly, though, the history of the German people.
That's just one part, though, you know? That's...
No, I'm good.
There's a rich history with Germany.
Oh, God. If I ever get to meet fucking H3H3, I'll just be like, I'm sorry.
Yo, like, my thing is, like, let's stop talking about Hitler. Like, let's get over that. Like, there's history before that and then after that. Like, there's so much rich, beautiful history there.
Which I some people would say the same thing about fucking slavery, but
yeah, I say the same thing about that too, bro.
But I would argue that no, we need to still talk about it, because if we don't talk about it, then the generations beyond us aren't gonna know about the atrocities to keep it from happening again.
I disagree, bro. I think we need to get over it. Like, it's so boring now, dog. Like, let's move on, like, man.
Think about this, right? Life is a vicious cycle.
100%. Right? Yep, true.
If we don't actively know about, like, if we don't catalog and categorize, like, all the fucked up shit that's happened in history, how are we going to know how to prevent it in the future?
I don't think we can, dude. I think it's a loop.
Well,
forever.
I think that we definitely can. I feel like society as a whole has way, 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 way more power than we even realized. It's just that the government kind of has us in this, like, chokehold where it's, like, tricking us into thinking, like, things that are not good for us as a whole, collectively.
But you're telling me you don't think AI is going to take over and make us the new slaves? That's going to happen, bro.
Here's the thing. I think that we're already too aware of that being a possibility for that to happen. Because you got to think about it like this. We program the AI.
Right.
So we can program the AI to not do certain things, a.k.a. not disobey, not do this, not do that.
It's too late.
Which, bro. I mean...
Sentient.
It's arguable that we have sentient AI, but it's also arguable that we can even do that? That we can even make sentient AI? Because what the fuck is sentience? You know, no one really fucking knows.
Yo, clip that. That's hilarious right there, bro. Damn.
I mean,
bro.
You know the fucking facts. Like, no one knows what the fuck sentience is. I mean, if you look at a fucking atheist, and the atheist is like, oh, we're all just animals, essentially, and God's not real. Well, then that fucking breaks the whole AI being conscious theory.
Damn, bro. This is a whole nother stream, dog. We'll be here forever talking about this. I think we should do this another stream. That's
not
good.
For real.
Because it's really good. Because it's really interesting. Because we're in those times right now. It's not like it's going to happen soon. Like, we're in those times.
I just think people be tripping out too much.
I don't think people are tripping enough, bro.
I would argue that they're doing it a lot. And I think that it's just people aren't realizing how much they're doing it. You know?
I feel that. I think that a lot of people have, like, a goldfish mindset. Like, we just forget and they go on to the next thing.
Definitely. We operate in packs. The only way to break out is to do some fucking mushrooms. Do a little eighth of mushrooms. That's the only way to break the cycle.
That's true, bro. What we gotta do is spike everybody's water.
No, dude, they gotta do it on their own. That's just fucking drugging someone.
Give the world
pretty
one
sure
deal
that's
trip.
Like a crime.
Dog, they're already putting fluoride in our water.
Sadly, yeah.
Damn.
Turning us gay.
Dog,
the water turned the frogs gay.
Dude, Alex Jones, dude, that dude's funny as heck, bro.
Oh god.
Bro, I gotta play your last record. I gotta wrap up the stream.
Oh god, I'm fixing to go to bed. For go ahead and play it.
For sure, for sure. Going crazy. Final record. I Hate Myself and Want to Die, album by Poop.
Going crazy, First script, think I need it lately. Doing drugs like I'm in the 80s. Going crazy. I ain't giving up. If you need my presence, then I'll fuck you up. Then here's my apology, cause I'm growing up. Going crazy, going crazy, I'm going crazy, going crazy. First script, think I need it lately. Doing drugs like I'm in the 80s. Going crazy, going crazy, I'm going crazy, going crazy. First script, think I need it lately. Doing drugs. Like I'm in the
80s. Damn. Oh god.
But that record, bro, it sounded like you were like just exhausted recording that one. Like you could really feel your soul on it. Like you work on
it. Yeah, bro. Fucking people don't realize like how much mental health shit really affects you, and like it really does make you feel like you're going crazy for a while, and sometimes you don't know who's an enemy and who's a friend.
Right.
Actually, like most times, really.
True. Right.
But I don't know, it's like a fluctuating thing. I haven't experienced psychosis in like fucking 2.5 years, thank God. But when you're in it, it's fucking scary. Fucking scary. Pretty much what that song was about.
Damn. I mean,
like going through psychosis was like the reason why I have like pretty much the reason why I ended up having panic attacks so bad and shit like that. You just be hearing shit that ain't there, seeing shit that ain't there. It's not fun.
Damn.
What's up?
Life is weird.
Yeah, bro, it is. It really is very weird. But that's the thing is like, bro, did you know that you can literally get so depressed to the point to where you start hallucinating?
Makes that sense. Like you're going a little manic a little bit.
Yeah, that's literally what happened to me. I was literally so depressed, I was hallucinating.
Damn.
Because I was already depressed before I took drugs, and then I'd start doing meth mixed with Molly.
Oh, that'll do it. That'll do it, bro.
And yeah, and then when I stopped doing it, fucking everything shut down and I just was hallucinating and shit. It was awful. I was hearing shit. I like got a shower and like heard screaming. I heard people screaming outside of the room. Multiple people. It was like so scary. But yeah, dude, that song's wild. I literally said, like, hopped off the X, I'm on Citalopram. Got a new man, bitch, I don't give a damn. Like, I said, hopped off the X, I'm on Citalopram. I'm literally saying, I stopped taking Molly, now I'm taking antidepressants.
Damn, bro. I mean, when you're a fascinating artist, bro, like, you record your soul into the tracks, and whether you're happy or you're depressed, like, you're literally recording your energy. And like, right now in my life, yeah, I'm suffering, yeah, I'm struggling, but I'm not depressed. But bro, listening to your music, bro, I feel your energy. This is like a really trippy, dark tape.
Yeah, it's like a horror movie, yeah, in a sense.
Wow.
But to me, but what's wild though is it's only a horror movie to people who don't deal with the problems. So to me, it's just me listening to my everyday life.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Which is wild. Imagine listening to this album and thinking, oh, that's just normal.
Yeah, that's crazy. I mean, there's a lot of people who just have it good and they don't know what that is.
Yeah, bro.
They have a different type of suffering. Like, there's different levels to it.
Yeah, bro. Like, they're like, mine is just like self-inflicted.
Jeez Louise. Going crazy, bro. Where am I gonna put it? Damn, bro. It's gonna go on Cool Record, bro. This one,
yeah.
It's like, banger can mean two things. Banger can mean like, it's a freaking awesome, amazing song that you wrote, however you're feeling. Or it could be like, yo, you can play this in the car, it's like super loud, but like, this is such a like sad record, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And not everybody's gonna vibe with the sad shit, bro. And like, my shit is like really sad.
Yeah, you
especially this. Especially like this project. It's like, it's kind of like how Andre 3000 mastered making Hey Ya a sad song without it being a sad song.
Eerie.
Except for I do it in a way, instead of like making my vocals sound happy and upbeat, it's my actual songs themselves, like the beat, the actual production of the beats that are upbeat and energetic, but it's what I'm saying that's fucked.
For real. And
like bro, like, I hate myself. Very, very pop, upbeat song.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
But I'm literally like, I hate myself, but I tell myself that I need some help when I ignore the help, but I hate myself when I can't just help but cry.
Wait, let me play a quick snippet on I Hate Myself.
When I know the help, but I keep on getting high, draw some help, but I taste some more when I can't just help but cry. Lord, just tell me why I can't seem to die. No more drama, I just keep on telling lies.
Yeah, I don't know why I put that on cool. That one's a banger. You're right. Yeah. What you just said was crazy. Like, it bangs, but it's such a crazy message.
Yeah, because it's like, I'm literally, like, telling y'all, like, the actions that keep me from progressing. Like, listen to it. I say, I hate myself, but I tell myself that I need some help when I can't just help but cry. Lord, just tell me why I can't seem to die. Yeah. Ignore the help despite open hands that might help. Like, I'm literally saying, like, my pride is I have too much pride that I won't accept the help when I need it.
Kind of like, would you say you're kind of like addicted to suffering?
No, I wouldn't say I'm addicted to it. It's more of a sense of like, how do you say it? Just not have ever experienced something different, you know? Nobody's given me a reason to not suffer.
How old are you, bro?
21. Well, 22. Sorry. Forget my own age.
Bruh, life is... I know life is probably seem crazy long because of all the suffering. But, dude, life is still so much life can offer.
Yeah, I know. And it was funny. I say, and honestly, very am and very truthful in how much I am depressed. But it's so funny at how scared I get of dying for how depressed I am.
Damn, that's crazy. Have you always been afraid of death?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Man, bro.
It's scary. Anybody who says they're not scared to die is a lying motherfucker, dude. You are a liar.
What I'll say, bro, is for the longest I said I'm not afraid of death. You know, I have a savior, right? I pray and I know where I'm going. But there's been times where I was about to die, and you're right, bro. It's frightening, dude. It's so frightening.
Yeah, bro.
It's so freaking scary.
Because it feels like the lights are just shutting off, and you're like, oh, fuck.
Oh, my God.
Bro, one time, bro. So I have like a little bit of a blood pressure issue at times, especially when I'm at like lower weights. And one time I took a fat bong rip and I hadn't ate that much that day. And I ended up passing out. And when I passed out, I got like stuck in this like purgatory where I could hear myself think, but all of my sensory, like, you know, things were completely cut off. I couldn't hear, I couldn't see.
Yeah,
I couldn't feel, but I could hear myself in my head think. And the first thought I thought was, oh shit, am I dead?
Gnarly, bro. Gnarly.
Yeah, and I sat there in that for like a solid 15 minutes. And then my vision slowly came back, and then my hearing slowly came back. And I was like, bro, what the fuck?
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Yeah, bro. It's fucking weird. Because your brain is still active, but your eyes and your ears stop working.
Yeah. Terrifying.
It cuts off all your senses.
Ain't doing that again.
Nah. It was fucking awful.
What we need is like in the future, like someone who's good at animations to like clip stories from this and like create a cartoon.
Definitely, yeah, dude.
That'd be insane. But Pook, I'm gonna have to put this is a amazing sad album, bro. Like it's a sad, devastating banger, bro.
The whole album. Yeah, bro.
That's where I put it.
It's like definitely a tragedy in a sense.
Yep.
But it's so good, though. I feel like it's like a timepiece. I feel like people can come back to this and listen to it. And if you truly understand pain, then this album will speak to you.
It will. This needs to go on Tumblr, bro. I think Tumblr is making a comeback.
What makes you say that?
Tumblr is where there's more people who let their emotions out on a timeline, on a post, where they can feel vulnerable, unlike Instagram, unlike Twitter, because of the chaotic comments. You know, Tumblr has delivered more of a safe place to be vulnerable.
But that's also where the motherfucking furry porn at, though.
Oh, word. For real? Hey, they need music too, bro. They need music too, dude.
Oh God, I make music for the furries.
Dude, that is something you could take over, bro.
I'll take over the furry market.
Yeah, they need love. They get a lot of hate too, bro.
Oh God.
You know I got the ears right here, bro.
Oh God. Lord have mercy.
Hey, bruh, Bapook, man, thanks for joining the stream. It was a good time. It's a sad time, but it was awesome to have you here speaking your truth, your existence, and then hearing the music, bro.
Has anybody commented while we were gone? I haven't been paying attention.
On SoundCloud or on Twitch?
On Twitch.
Nah. We had one other viewer, but they dipped.
Nah, sad.
It's all good. I'll end up putting this
in the VODs.
Probably Friday or Monday.
Hell yeah.
But yeah, bro. Better. Anything? Any last words you want to say on stream?
Oh yeah, fucking my little sister's gonna hate this for me saying this, but my a little lore backstory. We were talking about furries. My little fucking sisters are fucking furries, or at least were. I think they didn't. I don't think they understood just exactly like what like furries exactly are. I think they just were like children and were like, oh, people who are like a fandom that dresses up as animals. I like animals, you know?
Yeah.
And yet they didn't realize just how much degeneracy was in furries.
Unfortunately. Yeah. Everything's got to be perverse, man. Jeez.
Yeah, I think, like, you know, if you were to look at a kid, like a small child, like, doing furry shit, you can easily excuse it. But yeah. Then when you get, like, a 35 to 40-year-old, you're like...
Yo, don't where do you call those places where they go, the conventions,
fur cons or furry cons or whatever?
Don't invite Pook to the fur cons.
Please do not. I don't want anything. I do not care about your furricy.
That, yeah. Bro, what a way to end the stream. Good last comments, bro. Dog, man, get some rest, bro.
I'm finna, dude. I'm tired.
Man, thank you for joining, bro. I'll catch you later.
See you, homie.
Peace.